Looking to transmute some unwanted cards into a booster box? Look no further than ChannelFireball.com's online buy list. We offer competitive prices on cards from Ancestral Recall to Zombie Master, and we send payments fast via check or PayPal. If you're not looking for cash, we offer a 30% store credit bonus. Head to ChannelFireball.com/buylist to submit your buy order. It's faster and easier than winning with a pack rat.
Hey everyone, welcome to Cube Draft. This pick is going to be a bird of paradise for me, because I like starting off in green ramp. Taking a look at the rest of the pack, there's a Vindicate and a Vendilion click, but those are far more boring. Oh my, speaking of boring cards, we have a Treachery. You know, Treachery generally isn't the way I want to go with a Bird of Paradise after first picking. But there's also Thran Dynamo, so if I want to sort of force a ramp deck, then this would be the card to take. Otherwise, it's going to be this bad boy. And for now, I think since my first pick was so extreme, I'm going to stick with this guy. And we're going to go with a really fun deck, as opposed to this just normal, boring, just sort of good stuff deck. I like green ramp the most, so we're going to keep on going with that. Okay, so what do we have here? We've got some blue dual lands. Volcanic Island, Watery Grave. We also have Upheaval, which I, to this day, detest because it takes a lot of mana. Although when you have green ramp, then this becomes more realistic, so I think we'll actually take that. The other reason why I'm taking it is because there's not really a good green card for us. Boon Satyr is far too mid-rangey, and same thing with Stunted Growth and Thornscape Battlemage. They're far too fair for the range of cards that I like playing, so we'll go ahead and stick with the unfair cards. Alright, so maybe this green plan isn't going to work out, but there are a lot of good black and blue options. Recurring Nightmare is quite powerful. We could take Recurring Nightmare and still go green, or we can take Ancestral Visions. And also there is some Reanimator stuff, and Thoughtseize. Thoughtseize is pretty good. So I think what we can do is take Ancestral Vision and then see if any of this black stuff wheels. Ancestral Vision is, again, a bit on the fair side. We could take Recurring Nightmare and hope to wheel Reanimate. I think we'll go ahead and try that, because as much as I like Ancestral Vision, Recurring Nightmare is a far more interesting card. So we'll stick to that. Now here we've got Progenitus. Let's see. Replacement effect, so it doesn't really work with Recurring Nightmare. Although it does work with Show and Tell and all that nonsense. And so the rest of this pack has some white cards. Both Parallax Wave and Ajani are on the better side in terms of what White Weenie gets access to, cards that help push through extra damage. And we have some boring blue devotion stuff. So I think what I'm going to do is take this Progenitus for now, hopefully wheel Life from the Loam, and this will let us go into a sort of show and tell sneak attack sort of deck, which will probably be likely to make its way around to us if we end up seeing it. This pack is very boring. However, I think Phyrexian Rager is going to be the pick for us. War Miscalculation. Seems like green is not the color to be in, and so probably want to get out of it. We're not going to be getting too much help from our left with blue, because we're, we passed Treachery, Ancestral Vision, Purdane, etc., etc., etc. And the Thieving Magpie is garbage, so I'm going to take Miscalculation. Maybe wield this Rager. And here, there's Sneak Attack. So hopefully some of these multicolor lands end up wheeling. So between Sneak Attack, Recurring Nightmare, and that's definitely the start of something cool. So we'll go ahead and take that guy, and hopefully we end up getting enough lands that can cast our spells. Here we can take a Looter, or we can take a Silver Falls. There's also some white cards, which we're going to ignore. we're blue, then being able to get sweet fatties into our graveyard for Recurring Nightmare is going to be sweet. Also, if we happen to pick up any of the reanimate that was going around, then that'll be better. And I think we can go ahead and pass on this for now, on the Silver Falls for now. So we'll stick with the Looter. And I think I want to take this Crumbling Necropolis. As much as I like Dissipate and Steam Augury, those are just kind of boring. There's also Sun Titan, but in terms and Gamble, those could both be pretty good. But I certainly like the color fixing that Necropolis gives us. We're going to ignore this. Basically, this Bird of Paradise is just not here. So we're going to go ahead and take that for now. And Putrid Imp versus Drowned Catacomb. I think I want to take Putrid Imp because I want to be able to have a Reanimator Shell. And I want to be able to have creatures to sacrifice to Recurring Nightmare. And as much as I love the color fixing, I think taking the reanimated cards is going to be more important. Take this Bloodghast. It's going to be okay. We get a Bury Alive or something like that. Preordained versus Thoughtseize. If we're looking for specific cards like Recurring Nightmare and Sneak Attack, then Preordained is going to be better. But Thoughtseize is certainly one of the best cards to clear away opposing resistance, so I think we'll go with that. Now we can take a mid-rangey card. There's Life from Loam or Slaughter Pact. Now Life is pretty cool with in terms of dredging, but I think we'll go ahead and take the Slaughter Pact for now. And there's nothing for us here except for potentially Rugged Prairie and Scroll Rack. Ooh, we might play that if we get enough fetches. All right, so this pack didn't really start off as well as I would have liked it to. Our first two picks that we're kind of forcing didn't really pan out for us in terms of what was being passed to us. Ooh. Alright. So we've got a pair of Titans to look at. There's also a Badlands. And Stoneforge Mystic. We're not white, so we're going to go ahead and hide that. And I think it's definitely between the Grave Titan and Frost Titan. I like Grave Titan a little bit more. It's because it's better with Recurring Nightmare in terms of giving us creatures to sacrifice. And unfortunately, we're not going to wheel in either of these cards. Hopefully, we take the Badlands out of this pack when it comes back. But Grave Titan, that's certainly a card. Okay, so got a few wastelandy type creatures. There's also a Consecrated Sphinx and a Mana Leak. Mana Leak and Consecrated Sphinx are the picks for us, mainly because I don't really want to bother with any land disruption just yet. I would rather get good cards before I sort of get fixated on messing their opponent's mana base up. This Graven Cairns can potentially come back. The filter lands are more likely to come back than the other mana fixing lands I found generally, as you saw with the Rugged Prairie coming back second to last pick. So we're going to go ahead and take this Mana Leak. You already have a miscalculation, but we don't have too many fatties, and we really want fatties because we're reanimating stuff and playing with Sneak Attack. Granted, Consecrated Sphinx is not that great with Sneak Attack unless it's in response to something cool like a draw spell, like Ancestral Vision. Now here we're going to go ahead and take Seagate Oracle. It's great for finding cards that we want, plus it sacrifices itself to Recurring Nightmare, and the only other card in the pack that we would consider taking would be Shivan Reef, whereas Smother is a little bit on the mid-rangey side. Very replaceable, just there are tons of black removal spells, but not very many cards like Seagate Oracle and Shivan Reef. So that's that. Okay, what do we have here? Got Animate Dead, Wrenchmind, or rather, Hymn to Torok, and then Rashad Important Days. I wouldn't consider playing Jorolf's Messenger just because it's triple black is kind of difficult. So we're going to go ahead and take Animate Dead. First reanimation spell. Bam. Not the worst. Okay, so now we've got either Pack Navigation, Halimar Depths, or Spreading Seas. Potentially Enlightened Tutor, which fetches both Sneak Attack and Recurring Nightmare. But our fixing is not the best at the moment, so I think we should go with the Pact of Negation because it's a free counter spell, sort of. And free counter spells are the most difficult to play around. Now here I'm going to go ahead and take Tundra, mainly because if we do wield the Enlightened Tutor, we're going to want to be able to cast it. Plus, I mean, gotta cast Progenitus somehow, so might as well get started. I don't really like the alternative of taking Persecute, and Sensei's Divining Top is not that great when we're dealing with fetch lands. The only way to shuffle our deck so far is shuffling Progenitus, which is kind of weird. Okay, so here we've got Bayou or Undermine, or the card that we're probably going to lose to, Jotun Grunt. And considering that, let's see, let's do a quick cost sort. Cost sort. All right. So regarding Shardless Agent, we have miscalculation. Two pacts. Yeah, that's probably not going to work out. So let's go ahead and take the Undermine. There is the Bayou, but I think I'm going to go with the Undermine because it's our. We don't have too many hard counters. I'll take a makeshift mannequin here, or there's a rocky tar pit, but I think mannequin's going to end up working out better because we have the Putrid Imp, we have the. Let's see, we have the Looter, plus if we actually just cast any creatures and they die, then makeshift mannequin brings them back. And all of our creatures are pretty good. Wow. The guy who cut green off from us in pack one is going to get rewarded with a Rephalos that wield. That is just bonkers. What might be even more bonkers is that no green cards were opened in pack one and no one's in green. But now wouldn't that be interesting? But for now, we're going to go ahead and take Badlands. Because our mana fixing is, oops, has a bit of importance for us since we don't have too much of it. Here we can take Sphere of the Suns. It's not the best mana fixer. Because since we can only use it a few times, there's Graven Cairns, which could work out. Not really too much of a fan of Sphere, just tell you the truth. So I'm going to go ahead and take this Graven Cairns. And Shivan Reef. Again, I don't really want to run Smother. Just spells that are interactive like that are just not really what I'm looking for. I will take Daze, though. For days and days and days. Free spells. Probably won't end up running this just because we won't have too many island cards, so having it be a free card is not realistic. Oh, Enlightened Tutor. So we've got the Tundra. Could theoretically run this, or you can just take Halimar Depths. Don't have too many shuffling effects, so I'm just gonna gamble with this tutor. And again, a filter land second to last. And Etched Oracle. Well, we have Wooded Bastion. All right, I think we can backdoor some white mana since we've got the Rugged Prairie. Let's unhide this.